शिवोहम 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 शिवोहम। शिवं शरणं जय जय नंदी शरणं जय जय मूलांज शरणं जय जय शिवकामी शरणं जय जय श्रीमाता ललिताम्बिका राजराजेश्वरी महात्रिपुरसुंदरी शरणं मम। Shivoham to all of you. Today we are going to start the doubt clearing session with ID number 10008. This is question related to Sri Vidya level 2 and Durga Saptashati. Guruji, kindly explain how to do Chandi Homam just using DSS Moola Mantra or using the Siddha Kunjika Stotra. So if you use the DSS Moola Mantra and do the Havan, that itself is called Chandi Homam or Chandi Havan. So if you want to do the Chandi Havan with Siddha Kunjika Stotra, then for each stotra or each, you know, lines, you can add Swaha. For example, the Moola Mantra will come first, then Namaste Rudra Rupinne, Namaste Madhumardini, Nama Kaitabaharinne, Namaste Mahishardini, Swaha. Like this, for every two lines of Siddha Kunjika Stotra, you can add the Swaha and do the Siddha Kunjika Stotra Havan. But Moola Mantra is more than sufficient, because Moola Mantra is the essence of Siddha Kunjika Stotra. If you see that Siddha Kunjika Stotra starts with Moola Mantra, then only the energy will flow to all the other names of the Divine Mother in the Siddha Kunjika Stotra. So Moola Mantra is sufficient. If you want to do the Havan with the Siddha Kunjika Stotra, also you can do it. Now I am getting thoughts in my daily life that the same jiva or pure consciousness is there in every body, and I get thoughts that the same jiva is breathing through others body. Even if I remember the people whom I dislike, I affirm about that thought that the same consciousness jiva is residing in them, and any negative thoughts will be neutralized. I'm nearing to self-realization, Guruji, please guide me. Yes, you are taking one more step after the, you know, the self. You understood what is really self. It is not a body, it is not a mind. It is that pure consciousness, awareness within you and everywhere. So you have understood and realized this. And you are applying this realization, your knowledge in the outside world. Whenever the negative thoughts are coming, you are neutralizing by affirming the truth. This is very important. When we affirm the truth, that will give a freedom to us. You are affirming the truth and you are overcoming your problems. That is the power of the understanding of self. So I am not telling that you are nearing the to self-realization. You are experiencing and having a glimpses of self-realization. You are doing well. By the grace of Divine Mother, you continue with that. What are the advantages of being in blankness, expansive state in Soham level? Is it same as being in a soul consciousness? Yes. When you say that you are in a being of blankness or expansive state, then you know that who you are. You are not a body, or you don't have a form, you don't have any other qualities. In that blankness, that expanding state, you are one, experience the oneness with all that is existed as the same. That oneness is what we call samadhi. That comes with bliss, joy of understanding. So if it is not happening, means you are not still touching that.
expansive soul consciousness that you need to understand. That bliss has to emerge, that knowingness bring that, you know, ananda, joy that has to come out. Then you see that there is something, a beautiful feeling of elevation, freedom. In that freedom, you cannot be bound with any problems, you are not bound with anything else, and you experience that infinity consciousness. So that deeper inner satisfaction that you are searching in the outside world, in a different, you know, material world like money, health, relationship, is already getting in that state of soul consciousness. So that makes you be happy. Then you can express that happiness, that content, that satisfaction in the outside world. Then your problems will be getting solved. So that is one of the advantages of self-realization, and your domination over all the worldly problems. That is the power of the soul consciousness, the expansive consciousness, or that blankness. It is not just a simply blankness. It is with Sat, Chit, Ananda sthiti. Sat is there, truth consciousness. Then Ananda is there, bliss is there. So with that consciousness, you are in that awareness. Then the bliss, joy, that is something very different. I explain this. If you experience that truly happening, you forget your body, mind, word, everything. You are in that joy only. Okay, that is the answer. I am doing every day Sri Vidya Havan along with DSS and Varahi or Bagalamukhi. What is the maximum number of Ahuti can be given using Ghee, chanting the Mool Mantra? Currently giving 27. It's more than sufficient. 9 is more than sufficient. If you doing the Sri Vidya Havan, any mantra with 9 times chanting and giving the Ahuti is more than sufficient. Okay. What is the maximum number of Havan that can be done per day? Once in a day. Don't do more. It's too much heat. It will generate more fire element is active, and it may imbalance your Panchamahabhuta if you do too much. Sometimes when you do too much Havan, purification also is a problem. You start having a fever or some, you know, dysentery problem and all, acidity problem, if you do too much Havan. So once in a day is more than sufficient. Is there any Havan for Guru that can be done on Thursdays for offering gratitude and better spiritual progress and guidance? Yes, you can do the Tirumalarji mantra, Om Mulanji Nama, Om Swaha. Chant it 16 times. Before every Havan, I am not suggesting only on Thursday, we suggest Ganapati and this Sadguru Tirumalarji Havan. If you want, you can do it. If you accepted Tirumalarji as your master, then take his name, mantra, at the end add Swaha, give the Ahuti, minimum 16 times. Can Bagalamukhi Gauri Mantra Havan be done for money related issues? You can do it, you can do it. I have already given one of the mantra, in Bagalamukhi Sadhana for abundant money flow. You use that mantra and do the Havan for financial or money issues. Okay? From ID number 297. It is related to Mahapaduka Guru Mantra and other Sri Vidya Sadhana. Guruji, I have devoted my full attention to Mahapaduka Mantra, and as guided by you, I have started more japa and aligning it with the breathing. From past 5 to 6 months, I was having one problem with this sadhana that I was also not knowing, but you came in my dream and answered my questions about it. Dream was like this, as follows. So it was the form of question and answer. I asked the question to you. Whenever I see your satsanga videos or read any spiritual book, I'm dragging towards that sadhana and start doing Mahashodhis sadhana, and by mother grace, and also I start doing other sadhana, which I have taken diksha from you. And after 4 to 5 days, I again go to my regular Mahapaduka mantra. Then I feel very happy and peace. Okay. Then he has received the answer. This was the question he was explaining in the dream, and then he received the answer in the dream that. Then you must drop all other satsanga but start doing only Mahapaduka Guru Mantra sadhana. And Guruji, mother also directed me to read the scriptures written by Saint Dhaneshwara and named Amritanubhava, where everything is written about Shiva and Shakti. In the above same dream, I asked you other question. Answer was given by you. Actually, it is the second day I was doing the Mahavare sadhana for my health. It's okay. Whatever the the sadhana, whatever the answer you have received in the dream, you should follow it, because it's very clear, very beautiful answer you have got it, that this Mahapadaka Guru Mantra become your soul. It is so much active in you. Whatever sadhana you do, ultimately you end up with Mahapadaka Guru Mantra. So it has a living in your soul. This mantra is living in your soul, and that is why you are see that I feel very happy and peaceful when you do that sadhana. So it is telling that you are literally touching the soul consciousness and living in that soul consciousness. So it's very important that you are doing that sadhana, you continue with the same sadhana, and also follow this, what Divine Mother has directed to read the Saint Dhaneshwara, Amrita Anubhava book. It is very, very important. This Amrita Anubhava is nothing but Atma Vidya. It is so powerful book, It will help you to realize the truth, who you are, and gives all the explanation about you as a Jiva, Shiva, and Maya, and how to overcome this, what are the sadhana, how to awaken the discriminate or awaken into the soul consciousness. It's a very powerful one. You continue what you have received, what you have been guided into in the dream. Okay, the next question is from ID number 10046. Can we donate a Sukshma Shiva Mantra to our immediate family, our house, our Vastu Devata, sun, moon and earth? Yes, you can do it. If you see that whenever you make a sankalpa, as it is given in the web page, we are making a sankalpa for Pitru Devatas. If you mean by Pitru, means all immediate family member and far, members who have, long back, died, or who are, forefathers. For everyone, this Shakti, this blessing is going to them. So if you want, you can also do this also. For Vastu Devata also, you can do it, okay? And sun, moon, earth, for Navagraha also you can do it. You see, when you chant Om Namah Shivaya or Om, Shivaya Namah Om, it is a Sukshma Shiva Mantra that will, make or cleanses all Navagraha Dosha. Even if you make a sankalpa or not, this is a Maha Siddha Mantra that will remove all the doshas and blesses you all of that. Guruji, how to use a Sukshma Shiva Mantra to clear our karmic debts and obstacles? You see that you are doing already Sri Vidya Sadhana, where your karmic blocks or karmic impressions are stored in your chakra. When you are bringing the Divine Mother Mantra, is every mantra of Lalitambike is a fire. It is burning the karmas there. It is removing the obstacles there. That you need to understand, because if you don't understand what sadhana you are doing, how it is giving a results, otherwise what happens, you have this type of question. If you are doing a Sri Vidya sadhana sincerely on the chakras, you know that all different aspects of your life, karmic impressions are stored in your chakras. When you are bringing the Divine Mother Mantra, it is a fire that is burning the karmic impression that are stored in the chakra. So automatically, without a doubt, you are burning your karmas by doing the Sri Vidya meditation. First, you need to understand that. And when you do the, if you want, again, for Sukshma Shiva Mantra, when you chant the mantra with any intention, that will happen. For example, you can make a intention, Lord Shiva, please burn my karmic, impressions of this life and past life. You can do that and remove all type of obstacles so that I can experience peace, harmony, happiness, in this life. So be it. With this sankalpa, with this intention, then you chant the Sukshma Shiva Mantra. Then what happens? This mantra is going to burn the karmas. Okay. Now the question is from ID number 1367. Okay. This is about the, marriage life. My marriage is about to fix and my fiancé is also a great devotee of Sri Mata Annapurneshwari Devi. We wish to invite mother herself as our child. Please guide us the right way to invite mother herself to come as our daughter I have received all the diksha from you except Bagalamukhi sadhana and currently practicing only Sri Vidya sadhana. You see that whenever you are planning for a daughter or planning for a child and you want to invoke any divine soul, you should be very careful whether you really want it or not. When you want to invoke this type of, the Annapurneshwari Devi in your this, the purity of your body is very important. The purity of your husband is very important. When I talk about the purity, means it is not just taking a bath. It is how your thoughts are there. They should have a good intention, positive thoughts. There should not be any jealousy, all this type of feeling, negative feeling, emotions in you when you want to invoke Divine Mother as your child. Because if I want to attract the vibration of that pure unconditional love, means I should be a cup of that vibration, that pure unconditional love. Then only I can pull the divine source or energy in my soul, and then I can express it in the physical form. That you need to understand. This is very important. This is the expectation from you and your husband. That's what we say, pratyahara, fasting, and being aware, watching all the times the thoughts about myself or yourself or your family and the world. Everything is so important. So we call that as a purity. That purity is needed to bring such a divine Annapurneshwara Shakti. That you need to understand that. If you just want to bring any divine soul, then it's okay. What you do? You make a sankalpa. You and your husband make a sankalpa that we are ready to receive the divine soul that can help, bless me, my husband, my family, and at the same time, this entire universe. That sankalpa you make, and then you keep chanting the mantra, especially Srividya mantra, and then you invite that soul. And one more very important thing is, whenever this soul won't come after you become pregnant, this soul will come or attracted by you when you are one with your husband. So whenever you and your husband want to become one, you both should chant the mantra and make an intention, then only you can, with a sexual activity to bring this divine soul. This is the method to bring the beautiful divine soul. And one more very important, if we invoke Siddhas, if we invoke Rishis, if we invoke Divine Mother, most of this type of souls are not that much, helpful to the family, but to the humanity. They may leave the family and go to the social service and humanity. You cannot expect them to be at home. They like to be free, wander here and there in the company of Shiva, Shakti, Masters, and they walk on the path of the truth. So you need to plan before what type of child you want, what type of soul you want to attract in your life, and be careful about all the things. Expecting just having a Divine Mother is different, but after having to be in harmony, in alignment, giving a complete freedom to that child, divine child, is very different. Because if Divine Mother Annapurneshwari comes, she don't listen to you or anyone else. She will walk on the path of truth, and she want to do the social service, she want to do something to the humanity. She don't bother about her own food. She just day and night think about the humanity and the world. And she may not leave at your home also. She may go to the forest and meditate. She may go to the temples here and there. All these things are there. Divine souls don't want to be, sit in one family, only in one, place. You should understand all those things. Then you plan according to that. Next question is from ID number 10091. If we wish to do the achamana before above sadhana like Durga Saptashati, Raja Matangi, Patuka Bhairava and other, which one is better, Vishnu achamana or Shiva achamana? Both achamana is not needed. Okay, if you want to do it, you can do any of that. Yeah, that you like it. In our procedure, we have not given any of that. Okay. If you want, you can do the Shiva Achamana, Vishnu Achamana. Both will work. Because Shiva and Vishnu, in a Shastric point of view, Puranic point of view, they are two different deities. In Siddha Parampara, in the eye of a truth, it is only one consciousness. So, it is that Parabrahma Tattva manifesting as a Saguna Brahmana in a different form to sustain or do the some work in this world. But in the Siddha Parampara, when the main focus is for self-realization, God-realization, experience of Samadhi, it is not needed. But if you want to do it, do anything that you like it. Both will work out. Okay? Are anushtanas prescribed in our Siddha Parampara? If yes, then out of gratitude, if I wish to do anushtana of Batuka Bhairava once in a year, can we use the same Diksha mantra? How many japas might be advisable, followed by 1/10 of Homa as usual, which is most conducive time and mantra? We don't prescribe any anushtana separately apart from your life. If you do the sadhana every day, things will be taken care. And specially we suggest the same time, okay, same place. If I am doing the sadhana at 6 o'clock on Monday, okay, then I have to do the same sadhana 6 o'clock on Tuesday. The same sadhana 6 o'clock on Wednesday. So different nakshatras, different planetary forces, different energies will be entering on the same day, same time. And then you are receiving, when you do the sadhana every day on the same thing, all shaktis, the Navagraha shaktis, Panchamahabhutas, and nakshatra shaktis, and all other shaktis will start entering in your soul and empowering your mantra. So there is no separate anushtana is needed if you really followed every day the guidance that is given. But if you want to do it out of gratitude, then you can chant minimum 1,25,000 of mantra japa. Any like Navaratris are best place, you know, timing that you can make anushtana, and followed by the 1/10 of the havan, then you know, tarpana, marjana, shanti, and then Kanya Puja, you can go ahead and do it. Okay, but it's not mandatory. Again, I am doing telling that this anushtana is needed when you have taken the mantra as a upadesha, not as a diksha. In Siddha Parampara, mantra is given as a diksha. It is not needed. But if you want to do it out of gratitude and love, then you can follow these rules. Okay. And one more thing, when we do the achamana, what is that we are doing is, we are taking the water energized with a divine name and, you know, infusing in our internal organs. Then we do the pranayama so that the pranayama can be absorbed into internal organs. It is only possible when our internal organs are wet. To make internal organs wet, we do the achamana. That is a scientific way of doing it, and specially it is needed for the pranayama. Then you go for a mantra japa or dhyana, then nasa, all of that, then the, you know, meditation. That is the traditional method of doing in a yogic parampara. Here it is not needed. We are using the Sri Vidya mantras, and all these mantras are the soma producing mantra. They are the so powerful. Prana and shakti is vibrating in every seed, you know, mantra rupini is there, you know, every prana is in the Lalitambika. She is a Mahakundalini, Kulasundari. Everything is, she herself is doing, means if you surrender out of love, grace, everything will be taken care. I want to, you know, make it very clear, you know, clear about that, because these things, what happen when you mix the shastras and the, you know, Siddha's teachings, confusion will start. All these things will start. You see that I have been telling, when you do the sadhana with acceptance and surrenderance, what it means? Acceptance means the accepting the discipline given by the master. Surrendering means surrendering all my shastric knowledge, all my YouTube knowledge, all my bookish knowledge. I surrender all that accumulated knowledge. I keep it aside and follow the, you know, discipline given by the Tirumalarji, Lord Shiva. That is the path we are following. If that acceptance is not there, surrenderance is not there, then growth is not there, realization is not there, real understanding or the Parabrahma Tattva cannot manifest, Guru Tattva cannot manifest, the Diksha of the mantra cannot manifest. ID number 1074. Guruji, I have been practicing Sri Vidya since 2017. Doing level 7 and Sri Vidya Samadhi Siddhi Sadhana since 2019. I'm very regular with my meditation, doing it twice daily. My interest in Sri Vidya was for self-realization and God-realization. So my question is, what mantra should I chant all the time? Is it level 7 mantra, Soham or Hasvom Soham Shivakameshwari? I'm very drawn naturally to Shivakameshwari Amma. Please advise. You see that? Soham is the ultimate mantra for self-realization, God-realization. That we need to understand. So that is what I have given the initiation in the Sri Vidya Samadhi Siddhi. And also I have given the initiation for Paravidya Mantra. That Paravidya, I have explained how to do all of that. Soham, how to do all of that. Then I have also asked you to all the Veda Vakya, Aham Brahmasmi, Soham or Hasvam Soham, whatever that you have to chant it. Here you are asking what mantra you are going to chant all the time. Sometimes what happens, we cannot have such a faith, trust in one mantra. Even we know that this is going to give a fruit, but still our Mahishasuram plays many, many ways. Okay? So Soham is the best mantra if you are truly focused for self-realization, God-realization. And I want to little bit give the difference between Soham and Shivakameshwara mantra. Shivakameshwara mantra, Soham is of a pure consciousness, I'm telling you. Then energy. In Shivakameshwara mantra, both will come. Hasvom also come, Soham also come. So there, Hasvom adds the energy to you. Because this is the best healing energy that is needed to sustain in this third dimension, duality, and remove all the poisonous things, all the poison of your life. Whether poison is not like this, only that I take from the liquid. Main poison is our mind, especially the negative thoughts, negative emotion, negative intentions, and negative karmas are the real poison. Okay, that's what the esoteric meaning of worshipping Lord Shiva, so that Shiva can take that poison and liberate us, giving the Amrita. Okay, that is the esoteric meaning of that story, Samudra Manthana. So when you chant the Soham, it acts as an anti-poisonous mantra that will take away all the negativity of ego mind, duality, and take you to the Amrita, that is the truth, that is the realization. That is you need to understand. But Hasvam Soham Shivakameshwara also very powerful mantra. This is for Advaita and Advaita. For both it is there. If you feel very much attracted, you do that also. Plus you can do the Soham also. So that you feel very good. Sometimes you do the Hasvam Soham where you want to energize yourself. And sometimes when you feel detached, you want to be alone with yourself without worshipping any god and goddess, you just chant Soham. That way you can do. And Sri Vidya level 7, whenever you have a time, if you get bored with Hasvam Soham and Soham, you can go with the Sri Vidya level 7 mantra. Remember, the day will come where you drop all the mantra, hold to the only one mantra. At that time, you need to listen to your inner heart and follow only that mantra. Okay? The day will come where you will see that I should chant this mantra. This is more than sufficient. I feel content, feel connected and energized, balanced and ready to walk on the path of the truth. When you got that, even if it is a Shivakameshwara mantra or level 7 mantra, so you dedicate yourself to that mantra. Okay, that is I'm giving higher level. If you feel that is the thing, you can. The next question, I have this problem of hearing strange sounds from many ears, something in the right ear, at other times left ear, or even both. They are like a little bells ringing, but sometimes like a pile bells. Recently, I'm hearing strange supersonic sounds, like before a plane takes off. Nowadays, the sounds are going on non-stop. Therefore, they are very disturbing. They sound like coming from a distance. What are these? You see that? As we progress in our meditation, as the Kundalini goes through the chakras, as the purification of chakra takes place, and the chakras get activated, then our inner senses become active and we start listening and hearing the sounds of the chakra. Some of you may hear the flute, some of you feel, you know, the pile, some of you hear the bells, some of you hear, you know, the roaring of the ocean, some of you hear Om Nada, some of you hear the honeybee sound. So you will see many, many different sounds of your chakra during the meditation. And the moment you come outside, when you are busier with outside life, you may forget it. But again, when you become focused and bring your attention to your inner world and silence, again you start hearing all of that. Okay? So this is the very, very important, and it will tell you that your auditory person, no, your psychic ability, the auditory inner sense to auditory, to listen the astral sound of the chakras, and some people also hear the sounds of the celestial world, like, you know, Sanskrit slokas are coming to them. They are just meditating, they start feeling somebody chanting in a Sanskrit slokas, stotras, some mantras are flowing to them and all. Means their astral body is connecting and listening to the celestial world. They are making a contact with a different world, like Siddha Loka, Shivagiri, Vishnu Loka and all of that. So that is also possible. So all these things are the byproduct of Kundalini Awaken, chakra activation, that you need to understand. Now, one more part I will tell you. Okay, this is a spiritual point of view I am explaining. Some people also have a health problem. Okay, they have a health problem, and if they have a, this experience will be temporary. It is not permanent. If it is a spiritual, the experience is temporary. Sometimes you hear the bell for 1 or 2 minutes, then it will disappear. Okay? Then maybe different sound will come or no sound will come. That is a spiritual thing. If you are only one, anahata nada will be continuous all the time. That is like a kamakala sound, e sound. That is the such a e and ends with om. E ends with om. That is a kamakala we call, anahata nada we call. That is vibrating, that is the song of your soul. So that is a permanent, that sound you cannot say that, you know, come and go. It is you. It is the creative spirit or force of the Lord Shiva that is manifesting you as a shakti, as a prana. So it is a, you know, eternal current of that spirit of Shiva within you manifesting all the time. That is permanent. But all other sounds are come and go if it is a spiritual experience. If it is a health problem, then you see that 2 months, 3 months, you have that irritating sound within you. So you need to check that with the doctor. If the doctor says that there's no problem, you know, everything is normal, in no issues with your, you know, ear issues and anything, then you take one step back, reduce your meditation for 2 to 3 weeks, 4 weeks, and see that whether the, you know, sound is reduced or not. So you need to discriminate whether it's a because of a medical problem or it is a spiritual thing. So I have explained, if it is spiritual, it is a temporary, it will not be permanent. Only anahata nada is a permanent, and that will not disturb you, that will give a bliss to you. It is such a bliss, I cannot explain that. That is the highest, we call it as a, you know, Kama Sutra of higher consciousness. Means what you get the bliss in the peak of your sexual activity, the same bliss is magnified, amplified, you know, 100 million times. That bliss you will experience with anahata nada. So that is very different experience. So please check with this. If you are having too much of this, reduce your sadhana, take rest. It's very important. Sometimes not doing the sadhana is also self-care, when it is disturbing your mind and bringing imbalance in your soul. You need to take one step back, relax, take a gap of 1 week or 2 weeks, and focus on other activities where you are passionate. Okay, that is also you can do it. Okay. Next question. I feel very connected to Divine Mother for her darshana. Nowadays also feeling very close to Lord Shiva. But unfortunately, I am not feeling connected to Sadhguru Tirumalarji. And I am very sad about this. Although I am aware that without his blessing, I could not have came to you. Please advise, what should I do to improve my connection with him? You see that? when you are telling that you are very much attracted to Lord Shiva and Lalitambika, means you know that within them is Tirumalarji, in Tirumalarji both are there. See, God, Guru are the same. Whether you feel connected to Tirumalarji or not, it is of no need to worry about that. Why you become sad? Because of his blessing only you are having this hunger for divine mother, hunger for Shiva, hunger for the truth. It is only because of the grace and blessing of the master. You need to understand. This Mahasiddhar Tirumalarji is so compassionate, loving master. He will come and make that surgery in our consciousness that we crave for Shiva, Shakti and truth. Then all the attractive things of this world. So you know that Tirumalarji grace is there with you. You just think about them, offer your love and gratitude. That's all you have to do. Don't worry. Worry is again not good. Becoming sad is also not good. Okay? Remember, when you become a sad, not a guru, not a Shiva, not a Shakti, nobody will be happy with that. They want you to see happy. So just let go. And allow the time when you start feeling his grace, you feel connected with the Tirumalarji also. The time will come. You pray again and again to Tirumalarji. Tirumalarji, I want to feel your presence. I want to have your darshana also. I want to feel your invisible hands. I want to, you know, connect with you more and more. Okay? Do the Manasika Puja of Tirumalarji. Try to put your sincere effort for, you know, to Tirumalarji and create that, you know, emotion for him, and slowly, slowly, it is also possible you start, you know, feeling the greater connection with Tirumalarji. So next question is from 10,033 related to Bagalamukhi and Varahi. Guruji, during distance Diksha initiation process, you send amazing miraculous healing, which for that time being remove all pain, burning, suffering, stress and all of that. Gives a good physical and mental health. Okay. My question is, how we can experience, receive the same miraculous healing energy? Is that through any mantra, or please put some light on this and guide us? You can chant Shivakameshwari mantra. Okay. Hasvom Soham Shivakameshwari. It is that Shakti I am channeling you in the Diksha. So when you are chanting the same mantra with a sincere prayer, Mother, cleanse, heal, energize, balance, lift me to Shiva Shakti consciousness, I surrender to you, thank you, love you, then you chant Hasvom Soham Shivakameshwari, you will be lifted again. Okay. The next question from the same ID number. I have taken Bagalamukhi, Varahi and their Moola Mantra Sadhana, and they cause me headache, heaviness. Same started with a DSS Sadhana, but when I receive Raja Matangi Sadhana and I started doing this, for the first time I feel miraculous healing on my head just after chanting Raja Shyamala Moola Mantra. Now I am doing and chanting Raja Shyamala Moola Mantra internally during my day. It gives me relief from the headache, stress. Now my question is, what's the reason behind this? Why other sadhana was not healing me, giving headache, pain, while Raja Matangi sadhana is giving good results to me? You see that Raja Shyamala is the form of Saraswati, Sattva, Tattva. Vara, he has a Kali and a Lakshmi Tattva. Then Bagalamukhi is also like this. And Durga Saptarshi is Kali herself. So they have aggressive force to, you know, budge the negative things. They work very, you know, hard with heavy energy. But Rajashamala is very, very attractive, pleasing, loving, you know, pure energy of the Sattvic quality. Okay? So if this mantra Shakti is happening good for you, enjoy that. Chant more of that. Bring Divine Mother Raja Matangi more in your life. Thank to her. Okay? That is only the... Every mantra has a different energy, different, you know, results. So in your case, for your soul, Raja Shyamala energy is blessing to you. Continue with that. Next question. My father is going through heavy debts since last 12 years, and it is increasing as time going on. please guide me, what should I do for him? What mantra is suitable for this situation? I have taken Sri Vidya Havan from you. You see that. You do the Varahi Sri Vidya Havan, Bagalamiki Havan of money, you know, thing. Varahi and Bagalamiki is very powerful. Varahi is a Bhulakshmi, Bhumandala Adipati. So you make intention. Tell to Divine Mother Varahi, Amma, please help my father. Help me to overcome his, you know, money problem. Put the grace to him and help him to overcome all his situation. Then you do the Havan in his name using Varahi Mantra, Bagalamiki, money mantra, things will be taken care. Okay. Next question from ID number 10351. Related to Shiva mantra and taking a Diksha. I am currently doing Sri Vidya level 1 sadhana. Everything is fine. I energetically know that my energy body is being cleansed and some energetic wounding is being healed by the grace of Divine Mother and Tirumalaji. I have learned 51 syllable Shiva mantra and I would like to mentally chant this as part of my sadhana. Can I chant this after invoking Guru mantra and Tirumalarji mantra? Yes, you can do that. If not, at what stage should I include this in level 1? As you see in our group meditation, what we do, we chant this Mahapaduka mantra, then we chant Tirumalarji mantra. So in your case, you chant the Mahapaduka mantra, Tirumalarji mantra, then you chant Tirumalarji 51 letter syllable Shiva mantra. That sequence you can follow it. I would also like to take Diksha either Durga Saptashati or Raja Matangi or Bhairava Sadhana. But I am unsure about what Diksha to take at this stage of my sadhana. Can you enlighten me with your intuitional knowledge about what would be best for me? I think Durga Saptashati is good for you. You can go ahead for that. After some, practice in Durga Saptashati and Sri Vidya, you can go for in future Raja, Shambhala or Matangi Sadhana. Finally, I have been energetically drawn into the heart center ever since I had an experience of Divine Mother when I was 17 to 18 years old. Okay, that is about 25 years ago. There is something there in my heart, but it is beyond my mind's comprehension. It is difficult to put into words. It is an energy sensation that draws my mind there. This energy in my heart seems to have a consciousness of its own as it brings my awareness to it on its own accord throughout the day. Sometimes when I sleep, I go into that. Can you enlighten me as to what I have been experiencing? And if there is any significance of the heart center in Sri Vidya Sadhana, please explain. You see that there are two of the very important centers, in a spiritual path. One is this point, okay? Another one is this point. These two centers are the like a control room of the soul. Everything is controlled from this center and this center. If I see the soul vibration, that is more here and here. And because of our past life sadhana, we may activate this center or this center. When any one of the center get activated, our attention automatically, magnetically drawn into this center or that center. In your case, it's very clear that you have done some sadhana in your past life, that this center is very much alive, active, and it is something pulling you, and you are going there and you are feeling your soul is residing there. You feel grounded, you feel home, you feel connected, you feel, yes, you are within yourself. So I see that you have done some sadhana in your past life and this part is very much activated and you are going into that because of your past life siddhi. This is automatically happening to you. But what is important, you need to understand that this is giving you grounding, this is making you centered, this is making you feel home, and you take advantage of this whenever you feel down, whenever you feel stressed, whenever you have a negative thoughts, whenever you want to make a decision in your life. What you need to do? First thing is you need to bring your attention there, connect with your soul, and then allow the soul to take over you. Then you can overcome your problems. Okay, this is a very powerful center. Here we experience the soul vibration. Here we experience the soul vibration. Okay, so this and this are very powerful. It is happening to you. It is a great blessing of divine. Because of your own sadhana in your past life, you have been blessed. Utilize this siddhi, utilize this, you know, power, accomplishment to make your life more beautiful. Okay. Next question from ID number 10,334. Okay. Related to Sri Vidya level 1. Guruji, I have been doing Sri Vidya level 1 for 1 month regularly. I am also doing Moola Mantra Japa for 3 full malas a day. And now I am learning Khadgamala Sutra. I am not Indian, so it takes me some time to learn the proper Sanskrit pronunciation. Before starting any practice, I always ask mother to transmute my errors into a spotless sadhana. Okay, this is really good. Don't worry about the pronunciation and all. You see that always mantra has a power, I don't deny. But when you have taken a diksha, divine mother tattva, divine mother vibration, divine mother grace is active in your soul. So whatever sincerely you do with a prayer and intention, that will be accepted by divine mother. So you are really doing well, that you are putting your effort and also praying divine mother to take away all the, transmute all your errors. You are doing well, continue with that. Guruji, I have various health issues, arthritis, teeth problems, and neurological issues. And I was wondering if I should add the R Kriya practice in order to heal it. Yes, you can do it. R Kriya is very powerful. When your pancha pranas are balanced, cleansed, and activated, all the nerve-related issues will be taken away. And whatever the blocks that are there between astral body or subtle body and the organs are cleared, then more prana is supplied. Then what happens? The right hormones, right secretion of the enzymes, right chemicals that are needed for to solve our problems will be blessed to us because of the R Kriya. That you can do it, that can be very helpful. Plus, if possible, also, I suggest for any health issues, 3 things should be taken care of: what you eat, and what you breathe, and what you meditate. What you eat, it should be, even you are non-vegetarian, it's okay, but make more of vegetables, more of fruits in your food system. Especially early morning, breakfast, before breakfast, more fruits should be added. Okay, and fruits means according to your weight can be better. If you are a 50 kg person, then into, I think 10 times, okay, that 500 grams of fruits in the morning you can eat. Then you can go for any type of breakfast. For the lunch also like this, fresh vegetables. Okay, if you are 50 kg into 5, okay, 250 grams of vegetables of different varieties should be eaten for a lunch. First you eat the vegetables, then whatever lunch, non-veg, veg, whatever junk food, it's okay, go ahead with this. When you eat these vegetables and fruits, adopt in your life the necessary prana, necessary vitamins, minerals that is needed, absorbed by your body. Okay, I ask all students who want to grow, reduce all the refined food. Okay, refined sugar, instead of jaggery you use. Okay, all these cold drinks, change it to, juice, best juice, pure juice if you change it. And all the outside food to home food. And only during some time, once in a week, once in a month, if you go for a party, you may take whatever food, non-veg, any drinks if you want, you can take, I don't mind. But every day you should have a control over your diet. Health laws should be followed if you want to have a good health. And then what happens? You also pray, if you have a genetic disorder, you need to pray to Divine Mother. Okay? And use this Hasvom Soham Shivakameshwari mantra. I ask Divine Mother Shivakameshwari to cleanse, heal, energize and purify my DNA. Okay? And remove all the genetic disorders. Give me the good health. Then you chant Hasvom Soham Shivakameshwari for 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and feel that Divine Mother energy is coming, doing all the cleansing. And don't do it every day, because what happens when you are working with the DNA, the effect is very strong. You start feeling again your pain will be increased, or your body pain can be increased, your mood may be changed. So take a gap when you do the DNA healing. It is very powerful and very effective. Mother start working. The Kundalini has a power, because below DNA is made of nucleotide. Nucleotide is made of, again, different molecules and all that below that, energy consciousness is there. Their Divine Mother energy will work and change the DNA and all. So all these things are needed when you do this. Plus, when I say breathe, means more deep breathing you do in the before meditation. Okay, deep breathing in the protocol I have given, at least for 5 minutes. Deep breathing means your abdomen should fill with oxygen, then your chest fill with more oxygen. That is what I am telling. Deep breathing means your entire system should absorb the prana, the oxygen. That is what I call deep breathing. That you do it. And plus, if you add the Raja Rajeshwariya technique, it's amazing, I'm telling you. Such a secret Siddha techniques we have received, amazing results. You literally feel all the experience, the prana. So food I have taken care, then Pancha Pranas, either I do Srividya or Raja Rajeshwariya, both will take care. Then the meditation, that is the Srividya meditation, will help you. So when we work with all these things, plus Swadhyaya, our negative thoughts, negative emotion also affect our health. That also we need to take care. That is a Svadhyaya, self-analysis, being aware of negative thoughts and emotion. And with awareness, we dissolve those things, and then negative belief and thoughts behind that, we dissolve. Slowly, slowly we walk and we reach to a Shivatva, Parabrahma Tattva, divinity, and manifest our purpose of life. Okay? Next question from ID number 1425, related to Srividya level 1. When shall I cover Divine Mother's white light shield to protect my family member? Is it when I start covering myself or after completing the procedure of protection for me? Please advise. You can do at the same time for your family members. Means I am doing the protection shield, I am visualizing the bubble of protection shield coming to me from Divine Mother. At the same time, you make an intention, Divine Mother protection shield surrounding me, also my family member. In your way, just the intention is sufficient. Automatically protection shield happens for you, and separate protection shield happen to your family members. If you want, you can also do it for your home also, your vehicles also. I ask Divine Mother, surround the protection shield around me, my family member, home and vehicles. So be it. Then automatically it happens. Whether you visualize or not, it is secondary. Your intention make it to manifest. That you need to understand. So you can do at the same time. So it will take 2 minutes if you do it for yourself. It will take the same amount of time if you do it for all members, home and office, or your industry, or your factory, vehicles, whatever you want, you can do it, okay? At the same time you do it, it is equally effective. Next is from ID number 10257, related to Srividya level 1. Guruji, when I do meditation, I am smiling sometimes without my control. My mouth is smiling. Why is this happening? So you need to understand that some of you are smiling, some of you are crying, some of you are irritated, some of you become anger, you don't know the reactions are started happening as your karma or emotional things are released from your subtle bodies. So some of your nadis are getting activated during your meditation. Some of you are yawning too much because the vata is releasing. Some of you are, you know, having different reaction from the body. Some of you are, you know, gas is releasing because of the, you know, vata, you know, cleansing is taken place. You don't know all these things. What is happening is you are releasing your karmic blocks. You are releasing your emotions. You are triggering some of your nadis. You are doing so much in your inner world. You don't know how this powerful, how this srividya is working, how many levels of your existence. But luckily in your case you are smiling means it is a blessing. Good emotion you are in happening. Don't ask why it is happening. Enjoy that smile. Smile to Divine Mother, smile to yourself and continue your meditation. I started doing my sadhana in December last week. Initially it was okay, but for last few days I am feeling very sleepy during meditation. First round of chakra meditation I am very aware, but second and third cycle meditation I feel falling asleep. I don't know whether I am meditating or sleeping. Please guide me, Guruji. So it's very clear that when you are doing the first level, you are getting sufficient of energy. When you are going for level 2 and 3, it is too much energy and you are feeling too much relaxation and you are going turning, your mind is slipping to sleep mode. So in this case, what you need to do? You stick to only one round, no need of three rounds. So do only one round of srividya sadhana. Next question from ID number 10115 related to Pratyangira VKG. Pratyangira, Guruji, is it possible to do the havan of Kshem Swaha as you said in group meditation that it's okay to do use the japa of Kshem for Maha Pratyangira? You can do it, okay? Even you can add Om Kshem Pratyangiraye Namah Swaha. It will give a more feeling to you because it's a name is there, but mantra is having only single bija mantra. Om Kshem Pratyangiraye Namah Swaha. You can do that. That can be blessing to you. Guruji, is there any short form of VKG mantra as you mentioned that we should do VKG mantra where we invoke Lord Ganesha, but VKG mantra is too long comparison to Om Gam Ganapate Nama. Please guide. So you see that in children's Diksha we give a Chintamani mantra of Ganesha. That is a seed form of Vancha Kalpalata Ganapati mantra. So if you want, you can chant that mantra. Om Sreem Gam Sreem Ganapataye Nama, that mantra we can chant. Om Sreem. Sreem is S-H-R-E-E-M. Then Gam G-A-M. Then again Sreem. S-H-R-E-E-M. Om Sreem Gam Sreem Ganapataye Namaha. That is the seed form of Vancha Kalpalata Ganapati mantra. You can only do if you have initiated into Vancha Kalpalata Ganapati mantra. Okay? If you are not initiated, both mantra will not work out. Okay? Next question. Guruji, what is the difference between Sri Mata Lalitambika and Mahavidya Kamala? As both Mahavidya have a Sreem as a Bija mantra. I heard somewhere that Kamala Mata prayed to Sri Mata Lalita and got blessings of Sreem. Is Kamala Mata smaller Mahavidya than Sri Mata Lalita Mahatripura Sundari? No. Kamala and Lalitambika is same. All das Mahavidya Shaktis are same. Only one Shakti is there. Only one Mahashakti is there. That is taking care of all of this. When the same Kundalini in your Mooladhara, she is a Tripura Bhairavi. When the same Shakti in a different chakra, she is a different energy. When the same Shakti is in here, it is Kamala. Okay? So don't get confused with that Sreem and all. But you know that the Moola Mantra for Lalitambika is different, Moola Mantra for Kamala is different. We categorize all is as a Sri Kula Vidyas. So we call Sreem is connected to these two Vidyas. Nothing is greater, nothing is smaller. Every Vidya is the wisdom. Every Vidya is a wisdom is knowledge that will help to lift you and walk on the path of truth. Never make any comparison in deities. Remember, all are the same consciousness, same energy, same all of this. From one, everything has manifested, everything has a different application that we can use it, but our love, devotion should be same for all the, you know, deities. You should understand that. The next question is from ID number 1048. So related to level 7, Arkriya, Sri Vidya level 3, Samadhi Siddhi, Sri Chakra Puja, level 7. Guruji, level 7 say that we should not chant this mantra loudly. Otherwise, we lose the charge of this mantra. Can I ask if I can chant it very slowly so no one can hear it, as I feel so much comfortable chanting like this voice? Also, what's the difference between level 7 and Mahashodasi mantra? Is there any plan to offer Mahashodasi mantra diksha in near future? You see that I have been explaining in the workshop. All mantras should be chanted mentally. Especially whatever diksha mantra you have received should be chanted mentally. Because this third dimension, we are not only the one who is living there. There are invisible beings also living on this earth. We are sharing this third dimension with a different beings. They are, some of them are positive, some of them are negative. If you are chanting this mantra and even you are little bit giving out that sound, there is a possibility that invisible being can absorb or take away your mantra shakti. You don't have any idea how much negative things are playing at present situation. So we have made it very clear, chant it mentally. It is not that, you know, I am feeling good, so I chant it. No. After some days of mental chanting, your mind will be, you know, habituated, and you will enjoy that when you do the mental chanting. So never chant the mantra openly, loudly. You can chant Om. Om is the, you know, spirit of this entire world, the creative force that cannot be harmed. But other mantras that you have received the diksha should be chanted mentally. Otherwise, you lose the power of that. I have seen many times we chant and the individual forces that are there, they take away the energy. And what you do, your tapas shakti is gone. So please be careful. Even you put the protection shield, but when you are chanting mantra, your mantra is going beyond the protection shield. You are, with your own will, you are allowing to, you know, manifest that mantra shakti outside your body, aura, and to the entire space. And when this space is, you know, shared by another person, they can have a ability, they have a power to take that, you know, energy. So never chant the mantra like that, okay? Especially the diksha mantra should not be chanted. This is very important, you need to understand. Remember, I need to burn the karmas, I need a lot of energy to burn my psychic impression that are stored in my aura and chakras. If I don't chant the mantra internally, I cannot get the results. You need to understand all of that. Then what is the difference between Sri Vidya level 7 and Mahashodasi mantra? You see that level 7, what is the importance when we do the level 4, 5, 6, then we go to level 7, where level 7 has the energy of all 6 levels. So it is a last stage that whatever you have done the tapasya of all levels, you are getting all that power in one mantra and you are meditating. And also in the worship, what I have explained, the level 7 mantra takes your kundalini from Mooladhara to Sahasrara to your Parabrahma, you know, divine self or higher soul, and then it brings back to your normal Mooladhara so that you can function normally in the third dimension. You can manifest and balance spiritual and material world. That's the power of Sri Vidya level 7 that you need to understand. In Mahashodasiva temple, actually in some parampara, they give a mantra of, you know, Ganapati, Varahi, Bala, then Rajamatangi, then they give a Panchadashi mantra and other, you know, they have their own certain. All these mantra shaktis are in one mantra, that is Mahashodasi mantra. So that is all, you know, Ganapati, Varahi, Ganapati, and then Durga or the Varahi or the Rajamatangi, then Bala. All those shaktis are made in one mantra, that is Mahashodasi mantra. So after following all that stages, you reach to Mahashodasi mantra, then you will be chanting only Mahashodasi mantra of that parampara like that. That is the this. So I give this Mahashodasi mantra when I have been guided by Divine Mother to particular individual. This mantra is not given to the public. That is the tradition that has been followed by all the masters. All the masters have been followed that. It is like that. And it is given, otherwise if you don't prepare with all those shaktis, then even you chant Mahashodasi, it won't work. So there are many conditions, restrictions, all of that. So it is not a part of our sadhana. Srividya level 7 is, empowers all the mantras of all 7 levels and take to you to the self-relation, God-relation. So there is no comparison between this and that. There is no need for me to give again that one. But I only give to this Mahashodasi when guided by Divine Mother. And especially some students have done this sadhana in the past life and they wanted to help to the humanity. At that time I have been guided, then only I give this. So some mantras, this mantra Mahashodasi, Purna Mahashodasi, Paramahashodasi, Taradi Mahashodasi, Bhuvaneshwar Mahashodasi, there are 32 forms of Mahashodasi. What is needed for the person, I give only that mantra that is guided by Divine Mother. It is not asked by a student. So there are some people asking me, Maha Mahapaduka give me, Devi Mahapaduka give me, Kameshwara Mahapaduka give me. I don't give all the way the people ask this. I sincerely follow the guidance given by my Divine Mother, Lalita Ambika. I follow her, instruction. She is my guru, she is my ishta, she is a father, mother. I am here to serve her, not to fulfill the just people's intention and all. So I am guided, I will give only those teachings that is, as the will of Divine Mother, okay? Is R Kriya is same as a Srividya level 3 pranayama? Do I have to do both or I can get the same benefit R Kriya by doing level 3? No, they are both are very different. Mantras are different, mudras are different. The way we circulate the pranayama is different. Everything is different. The level 3 objective is different. R Kriya objective is different. Okay? Guruji, it is impossible to visit India to attend high level or advanced workshop. I am doing the higher level Sri Chakra. I know that. So he is asking that he couldn't able to attend the advanced workshop. He is waiting to do those workshop in future. Okay, you can attend them. Advanced workshop can be done. No need of rush. Srividya level 1 to 7 is the lifetime activity, you understand. More you do the Srividya level 1 to 7, more it will prepare you to receive the divine energy of advanced level. So don't worry, as you pray to Divine Mother, things will be taken care. The question from ID number 10153. Can I sometime do havan in my, attached garage or in a fireplace by placing havan vessel there? By doing so, I will be able to do the havan frequently and more freely. Sometimes we react to the smoke, smell, and I barely do havans or not at all. Will it consider that aroma leaves out through chimneys or just in garage? If so, then I can take a vessel out after havan and just spread the aroma to my home and family. Is it okay? I really want to do the havan sometimes, but not all the times. Don't worry, what you do, once you complete the havan, whether you do it at your home, you do the havan in your garage, wherever you want, do it and pray to Divine Mother. Mother, please send this energy. The havan energy should be distributed to my entire family member, to my entire home. I'm blessed, peace, harmony, abundance, protection to all of us. Make this sankalpa. When you make an intention, it is the direction you are giving to the energy that is created in the havan to distribute or where it should go. That's all you do, and do the havan wherever you want. Don't worry about whether the havan, the smoke is leaving the air. Let it go. Remember, there is a subtle energy that is expanding that we cannot see through our eyes. When you make an intention sankalpa, it will automatically go. No wall can be a disturbance for that. Energy can pass through the wall. Okay? So don't worry. Good thing is, you want to do the havan, start and do it. Don't worry about all other things. Okay? Make a prayer, things will be taken care. Next question from ID number 10299 related to Mahavarai Sadhana. Guruji, sometimes tip of my tongue goes numb only when I go in deep meditation. Why this happens? Okay. This is very good. Whenever we meditate, So sometimes we feel our legs will be numb. And sometimes we feel that hands is not active. Sometimes we feel entire the lower body below the throat goes numb. Sometimes we feel even the entire body goes numb. Sometimes only the tongue is going numb. So tongue is a representation of the mind. So when you are going into a deep meditation, your mind is attaining the stillness. It will influence the tongue. That is the one of the power of the Bagalamukhi sadhana. Bagalamukhi means she is holding the tongue. Holding the tongue means she is holding the mind, bringing the stillness. When she brings the stillness, you become aware of the truth, that who you are. That is the power of Bagalamukhi, inner meaning of Bagalamukhi. The real enemy is not outside. Real enemy is your own ego mind. She will hold the mind, ego mind. Then what you realize the truth, that who you are. So that is happening to you. It is a blessing actually. It's good that you are doing well. So go into deeper meditation. Let all that, you don't worry about what is happening. Your deep meditation and oneness is more important. But it's a really good result that it is happening to you. It means your prana is less in the your senses and in your body, and prana is moving to the height, to your sahasrara. It is a good positive sign for you. Can I light lamp in my clinic when I am on my periods? And please bless me, Guruji. I am going to start my journey as a doctor. Congrats to you. You are going to start as a doctor. It is such a blessing to be in that profession, to help Shiva Shakti in the humans, bless them with a good health. Okay, so you can light a lamp. There's no restrictions for lighting a lamp and all. Even in you during your menstrual period, light it. No menstrual period, cleansing is taking place. When you light a lamp, cleansing also takes place to your entire clinic. Lighting a lamp is very powerful, I'm telling you. It would cleanses the space. So if you possible, you can do it without any negative thought in your mind. Guruji, will Divine Mother Bala and Varaha come when we chant Mahapadaka Guru Mantra? Yes. The Mahavarai Shakti is there, Bala Shakti is there, Bhuvaneshwari Shakti is there. No, Kanchi Kamakshi, Adi Kamakshi, or Parashambhava, or Kala Samharani, Kali Shakti, and the Ananda Bhairava, Sura Devi, Ashta Bhairava, all these Shaktis come as a Guru Tattva. Please understand. Varahi work in a different aspect. But when we invoke her in a Mahapadaka Mantra, they come as a Guru Tattva. Guiding principle, they will come there. To awaken your mind, awaken your soul. When I invoke Varahi as a Dandini, Dandanata, she will come as a warrior fold to destroy the thing. When I invoke her to Shatru Samharini, she will come as an aggressive force with a different tattva to kill the enemies. So these deities, how we invoke is very important. In Mahapaduka, we are invoking them with a Shanta Swarupa, with a Guru Tattva that is manifesting in that Mahapaduka mantra. Okay. Now question is from ID number 10002 related to Sri Vidya level 2. You mentioned that only few can feel the Kundalini in one of your question and answer session. I talked to people who mentioned that their Kundalini is moving around and it reaches the head during meditation and etc. I was not sure how it feels like, and if I got that feeling ever, I have been doing Shiva Yoga, Durga Saptashati, Saundar Lehri for last 4 years. Is this normal? It's normal. Everybody don't feel the Kundalini. I have been telling again and again. If you are not kinesthetic, it is very difficult for you to feel the energy. You can see the energy, if you are visualistic, as a different colors. You can hear the energy as a different sounds. When it moves in chakra, it produces a different sounds. So when you are kinesthetic, you feel the energy and where it is moving, how it is moving. It's a warm energy or cool energy. With this energy, whether you are feeling a ecstasy, whether you are feeling a joy, or you, when it is burning any karma, you are feeling the anger. So, or you, when you are receiving too much energy, heaviness, all those experiences will be there as a psychic ability. Okay, but it's not mandatory. It's not mandatory. You should feel it. Because even if you are not feeling, the kundalini will be moving there. But you are not kinesthetic, you are not feeling. That's all. Whether you are visualistic or not, kinesthetic or not, auditory or not, you should not worry about all of this. Your goal is self-realization, God-realization. That you need to understand. Some are psychic ability, have a psychic ability, they feel it. Some don't feel it. Some are soul oriented, they only feel peaceful, blissful, that's all. They feel relaxed, but they never feel the kundalini. But it doesn't mean their kundalini is not awakened. Everybody kundalini is awakened when they have taken the diksha here. According to their purity of the soul, body, mind, that much percentage of kundalini is awakened here. So you should not have any thought that my kundalini is awakened or not. Okay, but your ability to experience may not be there, but it is there. Kundalini awakened is there. You just focus on your meditation, continue doing it, and things will be taken for your highest good. Guruji, I need your help in a few of my weaknesses. Sometimes my food, sexual craving is too much. I am unable to control. When I try to control, it multiplies. Should I try to control or just let it reduce on its own? Don't control it. Okay? Always balance your, all these things. If you wanted to eat something, you go and eat it. That's all you have to do it. Otherwise, your mind will be there. There's a universal law. Whatever you resist, that persists. So, what I'm telling, don't over-indulge into the food. Don't over-indulge into sexual activity. All that should not be done over. With a balanced, you can do that. Do not have the subconscious mind and body urges cannot be controlled with your intellectual mind. You need to understand. The force of subconscious mind, involuntary thing is 95%. 5% is only your intellectual mind ability. In many times you try to control, but it won't happen. It only happens when your all the nadis and chakras are opened, when your desire from inside, your attraction for that loses out, then only automatically things will happen. So all these things, controlling don't work actually until unless your soul is awakened, you have raised your consciousness, you have brought that in purity. Only thing I want to tell you, you control your negative thoughts. That we can do it. Control your negative emotion. What happens? We go outside, we talk about those negative things, we talk about, see those things outside, but when it is happening, that is all that we are doing outside. We are not maintaining mind in a pure level, but we want to control all that is because of this mind is not pure, then those inside things will be triggered. You need to understand this. Okay, now the question is from ID number 10228. Guruji, I have taken two additional sadhanas along with Sri Vidya, that is Durga Saptashati and Raja Matangi and Bhatkubera. Which protection shield I can use for all three? Kindly suggest. See, you have a choice to do the Sri Vidya protection shield or Bhatkubera protection shield, or you can do both the protection shield. All choices are given to you. Okay, so if you want, you can use all those three, but if you only want to use any one of that, use the Bhatuka Bhairava protection shield, where Ashta Bhairavas are protecting you from a different directions. Okay, that can be more powerful to you. Next question is, while doing Havan for mantras ending with Swaha, do we need to add again another Swaha? For example, Raja Matangi and Bhairava Mula mantras, and also for health mantra after Palaya Palaya, do we need to add Swaha? Yes. If the mantra is already has a Swaha, then you don't need to add another Swaha. That you need to remember. Okay. So when there is no Swaha, then you need to add the Swaha. So for example, this you are asking about health mantra. Om Aim Reem Sreem Achyutaya Nama Anantaya Nama Govindaya Nama Om Jumsa Mam Palaya Palaya, then you add Swaha. Okay, so I think it is clear. If mantra is already have a Swaha, then no need to add. If mantra don't have the swaha, you need to add the swaha for havan purpose. During my wife period's time, due to circumstances, we don't maintain separate rooms. In this, can I perform havan? Do I need to take any specific cautions? Nothing is needed. Do not have that thought in your mind. It is a personal level cleansing is taking place for your wife. When you are meditating, cleansing is taking place for you also. So there is no problem at all. You can do the havan. Do not, you know, believe in all of that. Okay? Just do the havan as, you know, regularly you do it. If possible, please make a children diksha distance so that people who are staying in other countries can utilize. My kid is really interested. She already learned Tirumalaji Shiva mantra. I just attaching the picture of Tirumalaji, which is my 6 years old daughter artwork. I have really seen that, you know, artwork, you know, done by your daughter. You know, it's a wonderful, amazing. It's a blessing to see a kid, you know, making a, you know, art of Tirumalaji. Not one Tirumalaji, so many Tirumalaji are there in that artwork. It's beautiful to see. You know, I really pray to, you know, Sadhguru Tirumalaji to bless your child. Okay, we will plan it. We will plan to have a distance, you know, children's diksha. But please give me some time. For the moment, I am quite busy here. But I will surely do it, you know, distance diksha for children's. Okay. Next question is from ID number 10134. Related to Rajamatangi Bhatkabhairava level 2 Havan. Guruji Pranam, my heartfelt gratitude to you for guiding me to do Rajamatangi and Bhatkabhairava sadhana for the marriage issue of my daughter. Surprisingly, before you suggested, twice I saw very beautiful parrots in my third eye during meditation. Once it was a white and orange colored. And next time it was a green colored along with a little bird in my medulla oblongata. After you suggested, I understand the meaning of seeing the parrots. Thanks a lot. Now I am doing both the sadhana along with my other practices. I am so happy that Divine Mother Rajamatangi already guided, given symbolically, you know, guided you to take this sadhana. I am sure you will receive the very good results. Please guide. For Bhatuka Bhairava, should I do the 8 Bhatuka Bhairava protection shield and invocation mantras and Moola Mantra of Bhatuka Bhairava, or just the Moola Mantra? Moola Mantra is sufficient, okay? The Bhatuka Bhairava Moola Mantra is nothing but collecting all the Ashta Bhairavas. But if you feel attracted, you want to do the Havan for Ashta Bhairavas, you can do it. So you just do it, you know, 3 times each mantra, each Bhairava, how we have done, or 9 times, that can be very helpful to you, okay? So all Ashta Bhairava mantras, 3 or 9 times, and then last Bhatuka Bhairava mantra, okay? I feel that Bhairava sadhana will help in getting rid of past life karmas that is causing delay in their marriage. Very true. But Bhairava sadhana is always helpful to remove the past life karma. Very, very, you know, fast, you know, results with a Bhairava sadhana to remove all the negative past life karmas. Very true. For Raja Matangi sadhana, can the Sarva Vashankara mudra be used for doing the rounds around the chakras? Also, should I use the same mudra for Sri Vidya DSS? I love this mudra and have always been doing it naturally. I don't suggest this. Sarva Vashankari mudra, that should be used for Raja Shamala Chakra meditation only. Okay? For Sri Vidya, it should not be. For Durga Saptaji, it should not be. You need to understand, the mudra should support the, or should have a same effect as the mantra. Then the mudra and mantra together, they give a very good result and bring a very, very beautiful thing. Raja Matangi mantra has the same energy as the Sarva Vashankari mudra. So the both together give the very good result. But if you use that in Durga Saptashati, it is something very different. You will not get a, you know, you may get a very, you know, different results. So please don't do that. Follow the guidelines as given by Sadhguru Tirumalaji so that you can get a, if you love this mudra, you can just put this mudra, and whenever you want, you do the, Uchchash Chandali mantra or Raja Shyamala. Apart from meditation, when you're watching the TV, you just put that mantra and be there. But don't try to modify the sadhana. I always suggest to students, do not modify the sadhana with your understanding, because Siddha knows better than us. Until unless we reach our Siddhatva, we don't have a ability to see the effect. So we may see temporary some good feeling, but it is not true, you know, result. So please follow the, you know, guidance, or sadhana should not be modified. Okay. Should the Moola Mantra be used for Havan as well, or just the Uchishta Chandala Matangeshwari sufficient? If you want, you can use both also. If yes, how many times do you suggest? Minimum 9 times, 3 times, that is sufficient. I am currently doing the Uchishta Chandali Matangeshwar Mantra 27 times. Really good, you can continue. I do the intention for my both daughter's marriage and compatible partners for the highest good, as you suggested. Guruji, please, will you send prayers for them? Thank you. Surely I will pray for, you know, for your daughters and their marriage. I pray to Divine Mother, bless and guide them to the, you know, best, you know, married life, and take to their, you know, higher path of spirituality also, material as well as spiritual progress, abundance in their life. Okay. Next question: can we do more of fire offering and less of japa? I am asking this because the power of doing the mantra in fire offering is 10 times that the japa. Personally, I love doing the mental chanting because it feels very good, and in Havan I cannot close eyes. I want to know the importance of two, how they complement to each other. See that Havan is a part of your sadhana. It should not, only Havan is not needed. The real power is mantra diksha taken by the master, that you need to understand, first thing. Second thing is mental chanting is very important because purification is needed inside. To awaken the fire element of the, you know, mantra, you do the Havan now and then, or daily, or once in a week. But don't, it's not necessary you have to do all the time the Havan, please understand. So Havan has its own, you know, different, you know, aspect. Your sadhana has, Havan do not give a self-realization, please understand. Only you turning within yourself, facing your own inner world and awakening your awareness gives the self-realization. Havan is good for just material problems to solve. That is only the objective. Please understand. It will bring a purity and manifestation of desires. But self-realization it won't give. If your, you know, objective is only, you know, outside world manifestation, Havan is really good. But sadhana is very important. If I don't focus my intention within, I am not transferring the energy or mantra shakti to myself. All these things are very important. Follow the guidelines. I do explain that 10 times more powerful when your kundalini is awakened. The equal power of the Havan start happening within you. When you have taken the diksha, your kundalini is awakened. So when you have done the sadhana, the outer fire ignites the inner fire. When kundalini is awakened, Havan is not necessary, I'm telling you. When your kundalini is too much, when kundalini goes above your, you know, manipura, no outside tools are needed. Havan you can drop, and all of that is you can drop. So, you see, the yogis, avadutas, siddhas, don't do Havan. Why? Because their inner fire is open. When they focus their attention, chanti mantra, it is the highest yajna that they are doing it. Okay? So, please understand, don't only give the importance to the outside fire. Give the importance to the inner fire. That is your kundalini. Focus on inner fire, because that is a true, you know, the power that can purify your past life karma, present life karma, liberate you, take you to the highest Shiva Shakti Tattva or Parabrahma Tattva. Guruji, I want to have a darshana and talk to Siddha like you. How can I get that? When I was 5 years of age, I had an intense desire to see a God, a divine being with a golden body and with a very radiant light around him, holding a kamandala, gave a darshana. I did not want him to go, but he went. I chased after him till my house, you know, and from where he went up and merged in the sun. I do not know who is he, but I have always longed to see him again. Please tell me how I can see him again. You see that this is the form of Agastya Muni. You know, what you have seen, it is the form of Agastya you know, Siddha Agastya, maybe he has blessed you, he has given a darshana to you. Because of his grace, you are following the path, spiritual path. When the right time will come, he will again show up and guide you. Okay? Maybe because of him or Kriya Babaji and Divine Mother Shivashakti blessing, you have been, you know, it's a great blessing that you, at the age of 5, you have that intense desire for God. It's very, very rare. You know, at that age, very, very rare. It means it's very clear that your past life is very much connected to the Siddhas. You might have, you know, very good student or yogi in the past life. Then only you have this intense desire at the age of 5. And you had a darshana of Guru, where he told you, means, in this life, I have given a darshana to you. When it is the right time, I will show you. So don't worry about all of this. Focus on your sadhana. Pray to Tirumalarji. Pray to, you know, Lalitambe. Pray to Lord Shiva. Things will be taken care. Everything will happen here. I am telling you. Siddha choose to come and meet a disciple. Please understand, when your detachment is good, when your desire for truth is so high, when you raise your vibration to a higher level, automatically you start meeting the Siddhas and all. But you know, you already met, so you should feel very blessed, thankful, and you are guided in such a great parampara of Siddhas, things will be taken care. Now the question from ID number 10013. I had a taste of bliss at the beginning of Sri Vidya, but since then I no longer experience it. What do I need to do or change to not just experience it once, but to experience it again and again, then to become absorbed in it? I'm currently in level 4. Thank you. Actually, this, you know, blessing of the bliss is not in your hand, in my hand. It is in the hand of Lalitambika Rajarashu Mahatripura Sundari. When you are just started the, you know, the journey and you touched that peak energy of Lalitambika in the level 1, you experience that bliss. As you started progressing and absorbing that vibration, when your body or soul vibrating the same level, then that bliss will disappear. So as you go to the higher level, again you will receive because of your love, devotion, surrender to Divine Mother. Okay? So the next question, it's as if you are outside of your body, able to free to of the physical shell. Is this true? Because you know each one of us and are able to send energy tune into us regardless of where we are in this world and assistant. Is this a siddhi or are you simply merged with all of us? Thank you. I think you are explaining, I am not clear, you are explaining the experience. If it is, yes, it is the experience of the soul travel when you see yourself, you know, in a meditation, you see yourself above the body, you know, outside the physical cell, where you see that you don't have a form, but you could be able to see the form of your physical body and you are outside. It is a soul that is seeing and it won't have any form. It means it is one with everything. What you are telling, it's very true. As I progress in sadhana, will this you know, physical shell and go and emerge out the other side? I am referring to pratyahara. Do we awaken into subtle body with subtle senses? As we progress, then we meet siddhas, ancestor, masters in higher dimension. Thank you. What you are telling is, as you progress, as you detach from the physical body and as you experience more of the cell outside the body, okay, that what you are referring to, pratyahara, detachment, do we awaken into subtle body with the subtle senses as we progress? Yes, as we do this chakra meditation, as we do this, you know, Srividya mantras with a mudra, we awaken our inner senses, we develop our intuition so that you are very close to a higher indivisible divinity that forces, as you said, siddhas, deity, pitrus and all of that. Okay? Do we awaken? Yes. Then meet siddhas, ancestors, masters in higher dimension? Yes, it's possible. When your psychic abilities are awakened, you can meet siddhas, you can meet, you know, all the master and all of that. But all of this is the secondary, because we are not here to meet a master, siddhas and all. We are here to experience the truth about ourselves, to know about ourselves, to realize and liberate ourselves. And siddhas and all other, our mantra, yantra, dantra, is a tool to experience the truth. okay, and it's not mandatory that we have to meet Siddha after, you know, making a, you know, physical, you know, from transition from physical to soul, all of that, okay. So next question from ID number 10022. Guruji, please let me know, can we use a sandalwood powder, okay, or sandalwood into the havan? You can use it, it's really good. It has a very powerful pure energy, okay, of you know, the pure energy, it is really good, sattvic energy, it's very good. Guruji, I'm chanting Lalita Sahasra Namavali from many days. I wish to do the havan on this. Please let me know, can I do it? All line in Lalita Sahasra Namavali ends with Namaha. Can I pour the ghee after saying Namaha, or do I need to compulsory say Swaha and then pour the ghee? Please let me know. Yes. After Namaha, you need to add Swaha. Om Sri Matre Nama Swaha. Om Sri Maharadne Nama Swaha. Like this, the Om, okay, prefix the name of the Lalitambika, then Namaha, then at the end Swaha. When you say Swaha, you need to drop a ghee into the fire. That way you can do the Lalita Sahasranama Homam or Havan, you can do it. Question from ID number 507. Guruji, I have been doing Sri Vidya level 7 and do the Vancha Kalpalata Sadhana with a Sankalpa to solve my health problem that I have for a long time. However, the problem does not seem to get better. I may need to go for surgery soon. Is it possible that Divine Mother is guiding me to go for surgery as a part of healing process? Or is it that I do not have enough faith, or I am not putting enough effort in my practice? Please guide me on what I should do. Yes. When we do the sadhana and we pray to Divine Mother, then also things will not work out, and then you take the help like surgery from outside expert. It is the will of Divine Mother only. Okay. So you can go for a surgery. Maybe that is the best thing for you to overcome your health issues, because a certain level the healing can take place at higher level where it cannot be reversed. At that time you should have a highest faith. You know, that faith is so powerful that it can bring a miracle. So in this case, you have prayed, you have did the best to, you know, to Divine Mother, also did the Vancha Kalpalata Ganapati. Means if it is not manifesting, means you need to take a help of expert and go for a surgery and overcome your health issues. Okay. Next question from 10,318. Bagalamukhi Sadhana. Guruji, Namaste. Guruji, in the first step, should I chant Om loudly or mentally? In the first step, I suggest chant Om loudly if possible. Okay. So that you can attune yourself, your soul to divine vibration of the universe. That is Om Nada. Second question. For mantra rotation in the protection shield, is clockwise direction is in which sun moves? Here what we do in the protection shield, we ask you to visualize the bubble of white light. When I say clockwise, means from right side to left side of bubble. If I'm sitting, visualizing the protection shield, what I do, the mantra should flow, float from the top of the bubble to the right side, back side, left side, front, then again right, back, left, like this way of movement, what we called clockwise rotation of the mantra into the protection shield. Guruji, I am doing Bagalamukhi and Sri Vidya sadhana as told in protocol. Can I chant 36 letter Bagalamukhi Moola Mantra separately for 1 hour? I feel blissful and healing energy while chanting the mantra. Yes, you can do that. For example, you can do the Bagalamukhi and Sri Vidya sadhana in the morning or at a separate time. And whenever you get time, at least half an hour, 1 hour, you specifically do this Moola Mantra Japa Sadhana, and it's really good. You know, if you're feeling the healing and joy and bliss, it's very clear sign that you are doing well, you are connecting very well with Divine Mother, and you are receiving the blessing of Divine Mother. You can do it. Next question from ID number 202. It's about Sri Vidya Sadhana and Siddha Healing. Dear Swamiji, when I am doing the Chakra Sadhana, I feel more comfortable visualizing my chakras in front of me. When I start writing and rotating the mantra in golden letters in the respective chakra in front of me, I start feeling vibration in that corresponding chakra inside my body. Is it fine to practice chakra meditation in this manner? You can do that. If you feel strong vibration by visualizing writing the mantra in the chakra, you can do that. It's really good. For Siddha Healing and otherwise, the very moment I invoke Sadhguru Tirumalarji, even before chanting the invocation mantra, I feel his intense presence and vibration inside my body. And hence, I chant the invocation only 3 times. Is it fine to do so? Yes. The invocation means feeling his presence. It is happening to you. Because if your devotion, surrenderance, strong connection with Tirumalarji, it's happening. You are blessed. You can do that. Okay, 3 times is more than sufficient. Okay, chanting the mantra 3 times is more than sufficient. Next question from ID number 1296. Okay, Guruji, I am currently doing Sri Vidya level 5, Durga Saptashti and Baglamukhi Sadhana. Myself and my friend do Sri Vidya Havan together on every Amavasya and Purnimitithi. I have noticed a slight variation in the Havan procedure given by you when my friend took Diksha compared to my Diksha Havan procedure. There is an extra step of Om Prabhu Shanti 9 times after completion of main mantras offering and also Tarpanam with water to offer to Lalitambika Yasdi Sri Devi Lalitambika Arpanam with water. Can you please kindly clarify which one to follow? These are optional. Om Prabhu Shanti was optional, that we have removed it. And this, you know, offering the water at the end of the Havan was optional, not mandatory. We have removed it. So it is optional. You can do or you should not do it. It's okay. So just at the end, now what we are doing at the end of the Havan, we offer the ghee into the Havan saying, Sri Mata, I am offering all the fruits of this Havan to you back, Sri Lalita Ambika. Arpanam, or Sri Lalita Ambika, or Om Tat Sat, whatever that procedure I have given, you follow that. Don't worry about Om Prabhu Shanti was optional, we have removed it because we have seen Sri Vidya is giving very good result. Havan is giving very, very powerful result. So it was not needed, so we have removed it. And this water is also not needed because my sankalpa, my intention is very important. Instead of water, I am adding the ghee to the fire. It is spreading to the entire universe, offering back whatever I have taken, the Pancha Mahabhuta material that is used in the Havan. So no, it's not needed. That was the extra step, optional. We have removed it. Okay. Can I incorporate 9 times each Ganapati Mantra, DSS Mantra, Bagalamukhi Mantra, Level 1, Level 2, Balat Pursundari, Panchadashi in Sri Vidya Havan, or is it better doing only 108 times of Panchadashi Mantra? You can include it. You can include all these mantras, how you are doing this sadhana, it can be good for you. Okay? You can include it. Okay? I have received a Kadgamala Stotra of Sri Vidyaranya Swami Guru Parampara of Sri Sringeri Peetam, which is slightly different to normal Kadgamala Stotra found. Do I have your permission to recite this Kadgamala Stotra? Your divine guidance is very much appreciated. Yes, you can do it. The Kadgamala has a 15 variation. Okay, so whatever variation that you feel attracted, guided, you can do it. Remember, the same Shakti will come, whether you use this Kadgamala and that Kadgamala. Okay, both have the same Shakti. There are some words are changed at the end, or that's, you know, last, you know, after completing all the things, when we invoke Divine Mother with Maha, Maharadna and all, there are some variation in the different tantra book and the way that is given in the Siddha Parampara or any Guru Parampara. So every stotra of Kadgamala works. So you don't have any confusion. If you feel that is more attracted, that you feel more proper for you, you can follow that. Okay. So next question is from ID number 10091 related to Arkriya Diksha, Rajamatangi. Guruji, I just took Arkriya Diksha on 12th Feb. In Part B, there are certain mudras associated with each chakra. In Raja Matangi Sadhana, we chant the mantra, okay, of the deity in a various chakra. Will it add to the intensity of the sadhana if we use the R Kriya part B mudras while visualizing Raja Matangi in those specific chakras? Or do we just keep it simple by keeping palm open in the receiving mudras all the time? You see that in this Raja Matangi, we use a Sarva Vashankari mudra. That you can practice with the Raja Matangi mantra. When you do the R Kriya, you use the part B mudra separately, but don't mix it. So when you are doing the R Kriya, that R Kriya activation, cleansing, healing, energization, opening of the chakra is very, very important. Once you do the R Kriya, then what is needed, the maximum effect will be taken place. And then when you do the Raja Matangi separately, as guided by Sadhguru Tirumalarji, then obviously it will take to the higher level. You don't need to mix those mudras or use those mudras in this sadhana. Please don't do that. I don't suggest, or I have not practiced in that way. But I know that R Kriya, when you do it as given, that will empower your chakras, you know, balance your pancha pranas and all. When your chakras, pranas, subtle bodies are aligned, then whatever sadhana you do, it is going to give very good fruits. So don't, you know, try to include those mudras here and all of that. You know, it cannot be, you know, it cannot be helpful. Or I don't think it is intensify the sadhana. Raja Matangi, Raja Shamala with Sarva Vashankari mudra, that will intensify, because that will something, you know, opening the key of the mantra. Sometimes mudras, the, you know, the combination of the mudras create a certain energy in the panchama bhutas. That energy become a key, keelakam of that mantra, that will open up. You know, I don't know how you receive that. That is how the siddhas have, you know, given some mudras with that meditation, with that mantra. So we need to follow like that. Then it will be very good result for us. Now the question is from ID number 564 related to Sri Vidya and Shiv Yoga. Guruji, I wanted to do Sri Vidya sadhana early in the morning and Shiv Yoga in the evening. Is it all right to do it in this way? Yes, you can do the Sri Vidya in the morning and Shiv Yoga in the evening or at night. Both are good. Guruji, sometimes while doing the sadhana, there will be negative thoughts and emotion that almost prevents me from completing the sadhana. Is it like there is some resistance as one progresses? See, these are all the negative thoughts and emotions are releasing from your subconscious mind. So that release is happening. If you do not attach and be aware and with a gratitude as a witness, then it will not hinder your progress. So that is the one of the lesson you need to learn to watch them. Let go and focus on your meditation. Okay? So next question is from ID number 351. What should I do to maintain health and energy in my retirement for me to be able to practice a minimum of 8 hours of intense sadhana each day? My age is 69 and plan to retire in 2 years. I'm very healthy. I have substantially transcended raga, dvesha, pancha vikaras, and my ida pingala are well balanced. All my life and devotion has been intense and deep. This is a blessing to know that, you know, you could able to feel the balance of ida pingala and all of that. Okay, so how you can do the 8 hours of sadhana? Slowly and steadily you can increase the number of rounds of Sri Vidya. In the last doubt clearing session I told increase level 1 of 1 round. Okay, if you are doing 1 round, you make it 2 rounds. Practice it for 2 months. Okay, then you increase it level 2 again, 1 more round. Level 1, 2 round. Level 2, 2 rounds, again 2 months. So like this, you slowly steadily increase each level round maximum up to 7 rounds. Okay, so this you try slowly and steadily, and whenever you feel too much, you know, energy, you know, distracted, heaviness or health problem, you stop it. Again, reduce your number of rounds. Okay, that way you can practice the Sri Vidya for minimum 8 hours each day. That you can do it. Okay, your age is 69 Okay, but as you with your all the question, I see that you are quite healthy. Without any health issue, you can slowly, steadily, you can do it. Okay. Next question. In your answer, you stated, do not consider Srividya in old age. This created confusion in me. Then you said that I should gradually increase length of my practice time in retirement, gradually while monitoring my emotion until I reach 8 hours a day, which can take several years of sadhana. Now I am practicing the following. Is this appropriate to improve my capability to reach 8 hours a day practice in my retirement? Please correct me of any misconception or any of these not required. So here maybe, you know, do not consider Srividya in old age. No, maybe I have told, if the person whose health is not good in the old age and increasing the more number of, you know, rounds may create a problem. But just doing a Srividya sadhana is a blessing, even for old age person. If he has started at the 50, 40, then he has continued up to 80, 90, it's not a problem. It is a growth, blessing and all. So in what context I have said, I don't know. But maybe, you know, in your case, you have a good health. As you said, you know, in the last also, I have read all of your things, that you are doing all the pranayamas, bandhas and all of that. And here also, you know, your food diet is good and all. So I think you have a ability to increase the number of rounds. You can do it. Okay. So now these are the sadhana you are following. Srividya and Samadhi Siddhi, 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the evening. VKG, asana and Kriya Yoga for 1 hour, 1+ hour each day. Additional practice over weekends to improve my capability. Srividya, Samadhi Siddhi as long as I can. Good. Is Japa of SV7 level mantra is an effective alternative? You do alternative Samadhi Siddhi also, you do level 7 mantra chanting also, you can do during weekend, so that you can balance energy as well as consciousness. Okay. Does Sri Chakra Puja over the weekend helps? Sri Chakra Puja is again good for material benefits, and if you use the Das Mudras, that can be also helpful to attract the Divine Mother Consciousness. If possible, you can add it, because when you are telling you are in a retirement, you want to spend your time, try to do all the sadhana that you have received in a different level, and after 1 or 2 months you practice, you will have one idea what sadhana is doing what for you. That can be helpful to you. I attended worship of Sri Chakra Puja, Shodasi Tithi Nitya Devatas in 2019. If you want, you can do Sri Chakra Puja also. Do I have to limit Srividya practice to a maximum of twice daily now or in future when my capability may substantially improve? You practice, you know, as you have been, now you are telling Srividya, Kriya Yoga, Asana, VKJ and all of that. Only my question to you, by intensifying the sadhana, what is you want to attain? Most of this intensifying sadhana is for physical immortality. We go for that. Okay? That is the main thing. And how much you devoted plus intention is also important. Okay? If you do normally with your intense desire to know the truth, normal sadhana is sufficient. But if you want to intensify, means the physical immortality you want to attain, or, you know, it is just you wanted to burn all the karmas in a short period of time and ready for that. In both cases, we intensify the, you know, practice. Okay, so make your, intention very clear. What you want? I want to burn all the karmas, experience the truth, liberate myself. That's really good. Or I go one step ahead. I want to burn all the karmas, experience the truth, and bring that truth consciousness in every cell level of my body. Then that is also the higher level. You know, as you progress, as you intensify 8 hours of sadhana, then you can think for physical immortality also. It is, everything is possible on this earth with the guidance of Tirumalarji and other siddhas. Okay. So do I have to limit Srividya practice to a maximum of twice daily now or in future when my capability may substantially improve? I suggest you first you practice it 2 times maximum, okay, with all the things, at least for 1 or 2 months. Then we will see how we can you know, manage with your protocol. Okay. In last week's doubt clearing section, you asked me to detoxify my by changing the food to fruits and vegetable. Please suggest or correct my following present habits. In any of these are not required, should I make any changes? So suffer fruits and salad and vegetables. Breakfast, one banana, sprouted moong, water soaked almonds, water soaked flax seed powder. Good, good. You are already following the good diet only. Lunch, low spiced, homemade South Indian vegetarian food. Our spices are okay. Yes, Indian spices are good, but should not be used too much. Good. I do not take alcohol and non-veg. Living in a small city in USA for past 45 years, we lived in a low pollution, you know, town or location. We do not eat outside food. Early in the morning, take pure honey, lime water, and small piece of ginger. Very good. Jaladoti once in a month. Full. You are doing really good. Okay, you are really doing very good. You follow the diet that you have been doing. So you are already, you know, following and detoxifying the things. So your health is good at this age, and you are ready to, you know, intensify your sadhana. So slowly, steadily, you know, increase the number of rounds and do the sadhana, and keep me updated if you have any issues. Okay. Next question is from ID number 10103. Meditation or chant Lalita Sahasrama. I have been doing Srividya level 3. Whenever I do deep meditation or chant Lalita Sahasrama, my shirt is getting attracted towards spinal cord. That is obvious. Even outside people can see it who are sitting behind me. Is it a positive sign that I am progressing? What happens sometimes, more prana we create, more that electric charges are created that will react our, you know, cloths. Of course, means it is this experience tell that your magnetic prana or the ability of the prana is increased in your body. Okay, this is positive sign of progress. Okay, can you please explain me the correct direction of giving arati with camphor? You just need to do like this. Arati, how we do for all, like this. You know, it is turning in this way. Arati. The God is here, I am here, the arati is there. You wrote it like this. That is the arati. If possible, make an intention when you do the arati. Divine Mother, please light my life, burn my negativity, bring the purity in me, awaken my soul, light my soul. Make this intention, then you do like this type of arati. Okay, that is how you do and pray to Divine Mother and do the arati. Arati is a symbolic to awaken your soul, light your soul, and burn the karmas and bring the purity in you. Okay, nowadays whenever spending time with me, people's clearly mentioning that they are feeling positive and thoughtless in my presence. But why I still have many thoughts while I am doing meditation? See, whenever we interact with other people, our energy also interact. Thought should be there whenever you are, you know, having a desires, whenever you are responsible, whenever you are attached to worldly things, thoughts will be there. You cannot say that people feel good, it doesn't mean you don't have a thoughts. Thoughts are something very important for you to live in this third dimension. Okay, so it is normal. Sometimes you have a negative thought, sometimes you have a positive thoughts. Sometimes you have too much negative thoughts releasing from the meditation. So this is normal. Only thing is you are, you know, progressing better. Your energy is getting, you know, more magnetic, pure, and people are noticing it and commenting on this. So you take it in that way, and thoughts will be there. You know, whether you are here or you reach very advanced level, temporarily you go into thoughtless state. Until unless you have a complete detachment, no desire at all in your mind and body and soul, then only you reach a thoughtless state. You walk with a thoughtless in a present moment, as we call it sahaja samadhi. Okay, it is a state of after a self-realization, after God realization, then sustaining that awareness, then it is possible that state to attain. Okay. Next question from ID number 10,339. Can Divine Mother Bagalam ki sadhana be done with low chant? How effective it will be? Please do mental chanting. Okay, that is the effectiveness. Don't do, you know, even the murmuring, the mantra is also not good. Okay. Is it possible to make enemies move far from us by Divine Mother Bagalamukhi Sadhana without harming them? I don't want to harm unwanted peoples, even if they are creating problems. May they experience their karma, whatever it is. I just want to make them move far from me. As you progress in your path, realization, whatever vibration you create, you attract those people. The people who are not in harmony with you, they will not be in your company. You need to understand. Only because of your karma, you attract those people. So if you want Bagalamukhi sadhana to overcome unwanted people in your life, make a sankalpa. Mother, I want to have a highest good people who can support, help, take me to the highest good or my divinity. You make a sankalpa and chant the mantra. Okay, that can be helpful to you. Can health mantra be chanted without Kechara mudra more than 9 times? You can do that. I think you are asking with a Bagalamukhi. If you want to do, you know, mantra japa without Kechara mudra, you can do it. Okay, now the question is from ID number 10,161. Guruji, I have received Sri Vidya level 3 sadhana in January. There are some issues that I am facing. I want to know the reason behind them. My grandfather died in November 2020. My parents went to my grandparents' home, lived with the other relatives for 15 to 20 days. While I was at home with my 13-year-old brother, ever since this happened, my meditation has been disturbed. So I was not extremely emotional due to his passing away, and I strongly desire to meditate regularly. Soon my meditation become regular again, only to become irregular. So why it is happening and all? So you need to understand, whenever some loved one, dear one, where our energy cords are connected, whenever they leave this earth dimension and or they are making the transition from this earth to the right dimension that they are going, you don't know what dimension they are going. At that time, that what they feel or face the disturbance can also affect the loved one or the one who are connected. So in your case, it is happening the same thing. You are subconsciously disturbed. Of course, you are telling that you are not extreme emotional and all, but subconsciously that memory center of your grandparent and connection with that his soul little bit disturbs you. Okay, so don't worry about if there is some disturbance is going on in your, you know, meditation. Pray to Divine Mother, meditate. After again few weeks or 1 or 2 months, again your meditation will be normal. So don't worry about this. Okay.
Shivoham, 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 Shivoham.